And the reason I decided to get inspired again was due to the success of the first one. And there's a common myth in uni that if you don't graduate or if you don't have debt with money, you can't do pretty much anything in your life, which I totally disagree. And we had some good speakers on the last guest event, Get Inspired event. This time I actually think they're even better. So without further ado, I'd like first introduce you, Rui Jorge and Octavio.
Do my thing. What's my thing? Okay, cool. I get to set up my own. Okay. You know what, that point of thing sounds magic. How's it work?
Just goes right.
Alright, oh, don't want to see that. Alright! Hello everyone, how's everyone doing?
We're good, man.
Good.
One response, that's it.
Wonderful. Hey everyone, how's everyone doing?
Woo!
Hey. Alright, cool. First of all, thank you, Daniel, for inviting me to come in and speak. You know, it's a pleasure to be here. When walking through university, Kingston University, bringing memories of when I was at university as well. And I'm not even going to lie to you. When I went to university, graduated in 2009, I was really, really excited when I went to university. Really excited just to be there. Maybe even as excited as these guys right here. Right? Everyone knows who these two guys are, right? Yeah?
Yep.
Yeah? On the right, we've got... Alright, my right.
They're both my true T's.
Pardon?
They're both my true T's. I taught them everything.
Yeah? Okay, cool. Very simple. Who's this?
Usain.
Yeah? And who's that?
Ronaldo.
Okay, Ronaldo. Okay, so Usain Bolt, this picture was taken... I think when he broke the record or something, but basically it's that race where he was miles ahead of everyone else. I don't know if anyone can remember. He was miles ahead, he even looked back, no one was there, and he started thumping his chest like that. What does that mean, if you thump your chest like that?
I'm the boss.
Yeah, I'm the boss. What else?
Greatness.
I'm the guy, I made it, right? Yeah? I'm here.
Yeah.
I'm the one. That's what he was doing. And Cristiano Ronaldo, he scored against Barcelona. Barcelona, and after he scored the goal, he runs and he says, calma, calma. For those of you that speak Portuguese, calma, calma. That's what I keep. What does that mean?
Calm, calm, I'm here.
Yeah, calm down, stay calm. I'm here, I'm here. And that won him the game. And here, Usain Bolt won the race. Some people might say, wait, wait, these guys should be humble, right? Should be humble, sportsmanship. Be nice, don't get all excited and stuff like that. Take it easy, you're getting too excited. Yeah, maybe, but you know, Usain Bolt, he's the fastest in the world. So if you're tending to calm down, you know, be careful, realistically, who else is going to beat him? Yeah, so in his field, in his area, he's pretty much made it. And Ronaldo, he's not playing against no Mickey Mouse team. Right? He ain't playing an Arsenal or anything like that. Yes, I went there. Right, this is the real deal. He didn't go and score against Arsenal, right? He went and scored against Barcelona, arguably the best team in the world. So he's doing it big. That's a big stage. So if he's saying, you know what? You know, I'm the best in my area. Like, but my mistake is that I felt like, I don't know if you guys know the term gassed, right? Excited. I was overly excited, like similar to these guys, but while I was that excited, boom, because I went to university. I was like, whoa, woo, I'm going Brunel, yeah, yeah, all right, mom, safe, yeah, safe, yeah. I don't even need that room no more. Right now, my brother's like, can I have your room? Yeah, you can have that bunk bed, it's cool. Right, I got all my stuff. Because I'm the oldest of seven, my house was small, so I had living with my little brother and stuff. So when I got out of there, I felt like I'm everyone excited. I thought I was going to another country. Bruno was like 35, 40 minutes away. But I got excited. Every time I'll come back to the weekend, people would treat me like I've been aboard. Oh, how was it? How was it? Yeah, yeah, with the coat saying from no university, excited. Right? And when I went there, I sort of forgot where I came from and who I was. Because when I was at uni, you meet people from all over the place. Like, for a while, I forgot I had brothers and sisters that were counting on me. I was like, student loan came, I got myself some trainers, my friends like, come on, let's go clubbing. I'm like, okay, what do you want to drink? I'm like, Coke. They're like, what? What do you mean Coke? I mean, what else? I don't know. Like, Christian background, I didn't even touch alcohol before until I went to university, right? Got excited. I went there, psh, dorm room, had my own room. I thought, woohoo! Got really, really excited. Met different people, started partying and stuff like that. Had a really, really good time. Got too excited. Too excited. But then, it hit me. Final year university. I remember sitting down, lecture. I did accountancy at university, business management accountancy. I sat down, the tutor started talking about guys, the balance sheet, profit and loss has to balance, blah blah blah. Then after a while, 2009 recession, all that kind of stuff, he put his stuff down. He's like, you know what, you guys are here, but real talk, when you graduate, I don't even know what you're going to be doing because the economy is really bad. I'm like, what? The economy is really bad. So then I started thinking, wait a minute, this little trip's about to finish. I've been here for 2 years, I've got like a few more months, and then I'm back in my area. What am I going to do then? Like, and you know, uni, you get to meet different people. I had my friend, a good friend of mine, she was from Cambridge. So whenever she went through sort of, you know, her money right now, she'll feel bad, she'll make a quick phone call to, you know, the father. He's like, hey dad, my money's run out, I feel so awful. And the dad's like, okay, cool, you shouldn't be spending money like that, but don't transfer. Money done, into your account.
Okay.
My situation was different. My situation was like, you know, I'm talking to my mum, mum saying, hey, you know what, your brother's doing this, and then we got this threat, and we need this, help doing that. And then she won't ask me, but as the eldest, you're thinking, you know what, I've got to try, I have to help out. So my friend, when she graduated, if she was unemployed for a while, it's like, oh my gosh, I don't know what to do in my life. Let me go to Spain for a bit, relax. Let me go to Thailand, just explore the world until I clear my head, right? If I'm clearing my head, I'm clearing my head in a tiny room at the bottom of the bunk bed, my brother sleeping at the front, and I'm trying to be a role model. In and out the house, and not doing anything. So I thought, no, I need to get serious. I really need to get serious. So I thought, okay, how can I stand out from the crowd? Because at that time I was really sort of academically focused. All right, let me try and get my A, a B, or a C, or whatever, and that's gonna do the job. But even at university, when I tried getting a little part-time job, these guys would ask me so many questions like experience. What experience have you got? What do you mean what experience? Bro, customer service, right? This ain't no complicated stuff. Like, I'm just looking for a simple job at JD. So, what experience have you got? Hey, thank you. Yeah, trainers, yeah. Oh, thank you, bro. Have a nice day. That's it. Like, what experience have you got? They start asking me these questions. Like, look, jobs that I thought I was going to get. Like, easy peasy. I might as well finish it up. Lemon squeezy, right? I thought I was going to get real simple. They said, what experience have you got? Oh, we're looking for this and this application, that interview and that and that. And I thought, what? No. So in terms of experience, I pretty much had nothing. No volunteering, no nothing, basically. So I thought, okay, I need to get involved. I really do need to get involved. So I joined the Brunel Entrepreneur Society, which is this picture here. Because I wanted to be around individuals that were going to push me. At the time, public speaking, communication, everything, life skills, it was really, really poor. But then I met some of the people from the Entrepreneur Society, and they'll go into lecture rooms and they'll start announcing, okay guys, we've got an event coming up and it's about being able to express yourself. And this guy was my age and he's talking to 400-300 people. I thought, wow, I want to be able to do that. And then there'll be meetings, he's talking to sort of head of departments at the university, trying to organize events. I remember my first meeting was absolutely terrible. But
how long ago?
Hello, welcome.
We won. Celebrated. Hi.
Hi.
Okay.
Welcome.
Hi.
Oh.
Yeah. Hello. You alright?
Yeah.
Good to see you guys.
Who is the president?
Alright, cool. So, I remember my first meetings that I used to go to, my first presentations, they were absolutely terrible, but I thought, you know what, if I continue to work at it, if I can improve, then I'm going to be better equipped when I finish university. And then from that, I went on to run events. The picture on the far, event in the community, because in 2008 one of my friends was stabbed to death outside the school. So we wanted to be able to empower young people within the area to be a bit more positive, raise the aspirations and get them into positive activity. So we've done that through the organization Nutmeg Community. From then on, I went to establish another youth project within the community, and even though I wanted to be an accountant, or I did accountancy after I finished university, and I did a little bit of work experience, work placement in the accountancy field, my all-time dream has been to somewhat be entrepreneurial, start something for myself, and I thought, you know, when I'm young is the best time to do it, because when I get older, more responsibility, I'm not going to be able to explore and be able to do that. So that's what I did. And then from then on, the many sort of awards, recognition, I was voted most inspirational young person of the year from my housing association. Featured on the BBC Tonight's the Night TV program, where I got to meet a few legends, or not legends, but Hollywood stars. And I don't know if anyone recognizes this gentleman here.
E.T.
Anyone know Eric Thomas? E.T.? Yeah? Yeah? Okay, a few of you. But basically, when I was at uni, I was, you know, doing work, I was looking for inspiration. When things went really bad, I went on YouTube and I started listening to this guy, and he was really inspiring me to sort of push forward and do whatever it takes to achieve my dreams and to make things happen. So last year I had the opportunity to go and meet him, to be around his presence, because I feel that it's really important sometimes to be around people who are doing great things, because from even what I'm doing now, it's basically a leap of faith. It's a leap of faith. Not many people in my community are doing things. So when I'm feeling low, I need to be around people that are doing certain things and are really setting the standards so that I know that it's positive and it's possible. So when I was around him, experiencing and hearing him speak and what he does, it really empowered me to you know what, do whatever it takes. Do whatever it takes to achieve what you want to achieve. So I'm finishing off now with this. Last thing, the message I want to leave you is be pushed forward by your reasons, not held back by excuses. Be pushed forward by your reasons, not held back by your excuses. Can you say that with me? Go on. Be pushed forward by your reasons. Wow, the enthusiasm is amazing. Alright, cool. Okay, I'm going to say this because I'm now working. I volunteered for Nutmeg Community, the organization I set up. We've been doing projects in the community for 5 years. I've been doing that for 5 years on a voluntary basis. You know, I had little part-time jobs here and there trying to sustain it, but ultimately the goal has been to try and develop the organization. Last year in July, we got our first big major contract, which is from the council, which is around delivering peer mentoring programs within 3 schools within the borough. So since then, I've been the only full-time member of staff within the organization. I mean, there's another one of my colleagues who's volunteering, he's helping out, but essentially, I'm the only full-time member of staff, and we're trying to develop and build the organization. And since, from when we first started to now, I'm not going to lie to you, it's been difficult. It's been really difficult. Filling in application forms, going to meetings, no money, wanting to do stuff but you can't. It's been really, really difficult. But my reasons, the reasons of the people involved, kept us moving forward. And I would say that we need to have really, really strong reasons. Otherwise, we're going to fail, or we're going to stop, or we're going to give up, because there are going to be loads of obstacles. Now, what are my reasons? The reasons are that I'm the eldest of seven. That's a strong reason for me. So just because I'm trying to help people in the street doesn't mean that my brothers are not in the street. So what am I going to say, hey guys, come on, you know, don't do this, don't do that. No, I'm trying to be a role model. That's a strong reason, right? My mum. I don't want my mum to be thinking, oh, what's my son doing when he's walking around? Is he going to be okay? I remember when I was walking one day, it was really cold. My mum was like, oh man, it really hurts me. Watching, you know, walking up and down and all you're trying to do and it's not quite working. Right, that hurts me. So that's a reason. I want to be able to say, mum, don't worry about me. Everything's cool. Right? Reasons, the community. This, we've done an event before, and about 600 young people came. And we're giving them positive messages. Guys, you can do it. You can achieve. You can do this. And then after a while, there are no more events. There are no more activities. What are we going to say them? What are we going to tell them? Hey, guys, you can achieve, but we haven't been able to. Guys, you can be great, but we weren't able to. And another reason is that my friend, he got stabbed and he died. And someone that was there, she said one of his last words was, you know, please don't let me die. Please don't let me die. So even though, you know, we can't bring him back to life, but for us, this is how we're trying to keep his legacy alive. And the organization is not where we want it to be yet. It's not doing what we want it to do. And if we just quit and say, all right, stop, then we're letting him die again. So they're the reasons that keep us moving forward. The reasons that keep us motivated. The reasons that keep us inspired. The reasons that keep us focused. What are your reasons? Thank you very much.
Woo, woo, woo. Anyone has questions or? Nah? Cool. It's a little time for Rui. Alright, cool. Now I'd like to introduce